First time over, trample on the foot, and you're next to me, you got your gig, you're finished, you must be really proud of yourself because you kicked ass on the stage.
Thank you very much.
Next to me is the family, Schnibbelen, Chris, Danielle, and Nick, if I'm pronounce it all well. How was it for you guys on stage?
It was great. It's a beautiful festival, a lot of people, great energy coming from the crowd. Can't ask for more.
What were your expectations before you went on the show? Are you nervous? Are you going to say that we're going to show them what we are made of?
Not so much nervous anymore, but you know, we just go up there and do our thing and just try to lay it out just the way we like it. And
back to the history of Trampled on the Foot, I see a footnote in the brochures that are lying down that you won the Blues Challenge in 2008. And then, what happened then?
Well, you know, we took up all the opportunities that led us to and followed through with all the festivals and the shows and had a really good run with everything and, you know, made a good splash with that. So it stuck really well, and so we continue on in that, you know, in that tradition. It's really good.
I noticed from the gig that it's quite diverse what you do, because you're a singer, you take care of some songs for you that make it a beautiful voice, as I may say, that made it quite diverse for the audience to watch. Are your songs written that way, that you're going to choose who's going to best in this song?
No, not really. We had our own projects prior to the band, and so, you know, our writing styles are very different, and there have been songs that he wrote that maybe that he prefers singing, and I haven't written very many songs from a male point of view before, so it's right, yeah. Right, yeah. It's a constant learning experience, and we've really kind of cracked down on writing and recording our own stuff over the last few years. So it's still evolving, and it's wonderful to see how it's going. You know,
how is the rehearsals going in the Schnibbelen family? Or do you get a rehearsal practice at home?
You know, not so much. We play five nights a week. You know, we tour all the time, so there's not really. When we get home, we're pretty much trying to run away from each other, not hang out together. But like this time, you know, we go home. We'll be home Sunday afternoon. We have a show Tuesday, and then Wednesday we leave again for the Blues Music Awards. So there's hardly any time to spend with families anyway. So,
okay, you're in Memphis, the Blues Awards. You're a nominee.
Yes.
Excited about
it? Yes, very much so.
Yeah, we had three nominations.
Three nominations. What does it mean for you if you win one or something? Is that a recognition for all the hard work you did, or what does it mean for you?
Exactly.
Yes. Absolutely. It's a culmination of a years long effort of touring and our songwriting and out in our album that we put out, you know, in our DVD that we had put together. It's accolades in the blues world and beyond.
Who's are your now? What made you the decision for you that you're gonna play blues, whatever you want to do? Who kicked it for you? Who did?
Our parents were in a blues band growing up. Well, they're in several different bands, country and rock, but they settled on blues in mid to late '80s, right when we were starting to grow up. So we were just around it from birth. You know, I always say we were always walking to the front room, skipping across the records that were sprawled out all over the floor. And
I heard that a lot. And it's a good school, your parents.
Yes, dad played guitar and sung, and mom's a singer, and they had, you know, they, like I said, they had blues bands. They played five nights a week as often as they could, and around Kansas City and some regional stuff too, and we just kind of took it from there and went on.
So it's not a key figure that you can say, I heard that record and made it for me.
We definitely ruined a lot of our dad's vinyl. We played it out, I guess you'd say, on our own as well as him.
And now you get him back by touring and make a popular band out of it. Yeah. Then you can just say to your parents, see you, daddy, it can happen.
Right, right, it paid off, it paid off.
Hey, what are your plans for Europe and especially Holland? Because it was a fabulous show. There must be some requests for you to come again.
We've had a few. We had a few people just today talk about other festivals, and we just put them in contact with our management and our team, and we'll nurture those relationships, just like we did in Norway. This is probably like our eighth tour that we've done over there over the last 3 years, 4 years. So we're just keep expanding.
Expanding.
Keep yes.
Yes. Writing and expanding and playing.
What's the most fun part? The playing or the writing?
The driving. That's the most fun
part. Yeah, hauling all the gear. Yeah, you know. No, it's actually, you know, I love doing the performances, and I'm really getting a lot into the writing right now, more so than I have over the last few years. So it's a whole new facet of the music for me. So I'm really getting a kick out of writing lately.
And by pretty soon is upright bass.
I'm really wanting to. I've been looking on Facebook and asking where I can find a left-handed one for under $3,000, you know, because they have to be built from the ground up.
Okay, you're not changing the strings on it? It won't help.
No, the insides are different, the way the neck is.
I saw you both play left hand.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yes, and it's not as easy as it is with an electric where you just change the bridge and then it's got to be completely built left-handed, so it's money.
Make a couple of tours and probably we'll put it on the rider. Let them deal with it.
Pizza, upright bass, you know.
And Wi-Fi, you never tell room.
Wi-Fi.
The plans. Next CD. Your CD is, when was released? Last year, I guess.
Yes, it was last spring is when our official release of the album was, and it's done very well, and people are already asking when the next one is coming. So we're finishing up writing it right now, and so we will head into the studio later this year and hopefully release it at the beginning of next year.
When do you write? On tour or at home?
Both.
Who comes up with you there, with the lick and the guys listen here?
We all kind of write individually, and then we start the songs off individually and then bring them to the group to finish them up and to, you know, decide which ones we're going to go with and which songs we're going to, you know, leave for the next record maybe or whatever.
This album, May I Be Excused, the one before, The Wrong Side, we were on our way from Kansas City to Philadelphia. We wrote three songs just in the van on the way, you know, so when inspiration hits, you gotta latch on.
It's better than flying because you were there in a jiffy and now you got time enough to write.
Right.
I'm gonna wrap it up, guys. I'm gonna thank you for this interview, and I hope I'm gonna see you and catch you on stage very, very soon somewhere. In Holland,
yes, thank you so much for taking the time.